Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Watch the video till the end, and if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon. Today we have a topic with us is cash flow returns on investments. It's as simple as that, you know, how much cash flow as a part of the return that goes with your investment that you have pitched in as a part of your money. This is the example of Starbucks Corp's capital employed and the cash from operations. So the capital employed was 18.47 billion. Cash flow from the operation goes around 11.94 billion. There was a significant rise in both the scenario, and the jump has been taken. There's a huge jump that has been seen from 2018 itself. So what exactly this ratio is all about, we are trying to understand. First, what is the CFROI? Okay, the CFROI or cash flow, or it is also known as your IRR of the company, as it is compared with the hurdle rate. It is compared with the hurdle rate to the understand whether the profit or the investment is doing well or not. Like, it was designed by Holt Value Associates. Now the measure all allows the investor to go into the internal structure of the company to find out how cash is created in the organization. It helps you to understand, you know, how company finances its operations and how financial providers are being paid. Moreover, you know, the cash flow returns on investments also takes inflation into account. So CFROI is a valuation model. It's a valuation model, and at the same time, it does not take into account the performance or the earnings of the company, right? So we'll try and understand the formula for this particular concept. The CFROI is equal to the OCF divided by the capital employed. So to be able to calculate the CFROI, we need to understand both the OCF and CE, right? So let's understand them one by one. First is OCF, that is operating cash flow. In simple terms, the operating cash flow is the amount of the cash that comes in after paying operating expenses for the company. So, well, we will first look at the net income and do following adjustments according to the indirect method of cash flow. OCF is equal to your net income plus your non-cash expenses plus changes in working cap. Okay, now capital employed. See, let's look at the capital employed part. It is, okay, I'll again say it. It is net income. The CF operating cash flow is your net income plus non-cash expenditure plus changes in working capital. And CFROI formula is operating cash flow divided by the capital employed. Now we'll discuss CE. The CE of the company use two usual means or measures to calculate the capital employed. Here are the two ways to find out the capital employed. No matter which we use, we need to remain consistent in our approach. The capital employed is equal to your fixed assets plus your working capital, right? And second, your capital employed is equal to your total assets less your current liabilities, right? The second method is easier, and in the example section we'll use the second method to ascertain the capital employed. Back on the Starbucks example, the chart that we saw over here, you know, the operating cash flow standing at 11.94 billion and the capital employed standing at 18.47 billion, so the CFROI will be is equal to the CFROI is going to be is equal to 11.94 divided by 18.47. That's going to be 64.67%. Okay, so we have got the percentage, but how to interpret? So that is our next topic of discussion. That is the interpretation part. Interpret the CFROI. The CFROI cannot be interpreted without comparing it to the hurdle rate. So usually the hurdle rate is the weighted average cost of capital, the WACC. Okay. Now, once the CFROI is calculated, it is compared with the CFROI is compared with the WACC, and then the net CFROI is calculated. So, here's how we can calculate CFROI: the cash flow from return on investment less the weighted average cost of capital. Right. So, if the net CFROI is, let's say, positive, that is the CFROI is greater than the WACC, then it increases the value of the shareholders. And if the net CFROI is, let's say, negative, that is the CFROI is less than the WACC, then it decreases the value of the shareholders. Now let's understand the example. See, let's say Ms. Shwe has been thinking of investing in Q company, but before investing, she wants to know whether Q company would be able to appreciate her value as a shareholder. So she decided to find out the cash flow return on investment and the net CFROI, right? So she has some of the following details, something like this. Details are something like this: net income, depreciation, deferred tax, account receivables, inventories, and so on and so forth. It goes around with a couple of details. We have the above information available, and first we'll try to calculate over here the OCF, that is the operating cash flow. So we'll try and incorporate this first. So let's try and incorporate the numbers. We'll start with OCF here. We'll start with net income. So net income over here is 6 lakh plus any non-cash expenditures. Just add over here. Okay. Non-cash expenditure will be depreciation, amortization, deferred tax, both of them above. So we'll take down all those numbers here. Okay. So, and now we'll have to add any increase in the or the changes in the working capital, okay, which will be increase in account receivable, decrease in inventory, accounts payable, and all of this above. Let's take down the numbers here. Increase in account receivable has to be deducted. This will be decrease in inventory has to be added. Decrease in account payable, decrease in liability should be deducted, and this will be added. Okay, now any increase in the accrued, the profit on the sale of property will be deducted. So we'll take down that number here, 12,000. So now we'll get from this above cash flow from operating activities. Okay, so that will be, just take down all the numbers, just sum it up, everything is equal to sum all these numbers out here. So it's 646,700. So we have the component of the CFR. We need to calculate the another one, that is capital. So for capital employed, we need total assets, that is A, right? Then current liability, that's B. And then there will be capital employed, that is A minus, right? Let's get the total assets here, 32 lakh, current liabilities, 4 lakh. And capital employed will be 32 lakh minus 4 lakh, that is 28 lakh. So here's the cash flow return on investment of Q company, that is the cash flow return on the investment formula. CFROI is equal to, just get the numbers out here, CFROI 646,700 divided by 28 lakh, and that gives us 23.1%. So to know hurdle rate and to compare the cash flow return on investment with it, we need to first compute the WACC and find out the same. If you calculate over here, the WACC, it's a long process, but it comes down to 4.06. Then the net cash flow return on investment is 23.10 as for CFROI and WACC. So the net cash flow return on investment is going to be 23 minus 4.6, 23, this is percentage, so it's gonna be 0.06, that is 19.04. So from the above, Shwe is now confident that Q company will be able to appreciate the investment she would be making. As a result, she would go ahead and invest into the company. So in the final analysis, CFROI is one of the best measure if you want to know an accurate picture of how company is doing. Other accounting ratio work, but they are based on the flawed idea that more profit means, you know, better resources and management and better returns. But in actual sense, how much cash is coming and how much is going out is what is important and will always decide how a company is doing in terms of the performance in the market. And every investor should calculate the CFROI and the net cash flow returns on investment before investing into any company. So that's it for this particular topic. I thank you. If you have learned and, you know, liked the video, if you think that, you know, if you have enjoyed and learned watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.